Because the sling is rotating, the physics of rotating reference frames can help us understand the interaction between sling and projectile. The sling pouch turns backwards on release. The release cord stays back as it opens. It is the Coriolis effect in action. On an instant release, the projectile would maintain a straight tangential trajectory in relation to the sling path. In reality, the projectile pulls the sling and there is a net change of momentum. The retention cannot move radially because of the finger loop, so it continues the circular motion almost unaffected. The release cord is now free and can move radially. The pull from the projectile adds outward radial speed on the release cord and it follows a motion affected by the Coriolis force. The initial speed of the release knot is the addition of the hand speed and the radial speed gained by the projectile. These speeds have opposite components and are relatively low compared to the projectile speed. From the camera point of view, the release knot can be seen with lower velocity than the arm for the first milliseconds. It later gains up speed as the projectile and the retention cord move away and pull on it, and the wave travels along its length. The motion of the cords turns the pouch 90 degrees, with its outer side facing the target and the inner side facing back. This turning can happen fast or slow while the projectile is still in contact. The mass of the release cord is a significant factor on the deflection and the duration of contact between pouch and projectile. A projectile of a given mass will be released later with a heavy release cord, pulled away from the tangent at the point of release. This is easy to observe when changing from light to heavier slings. There will be a greater exchange of momentum between a heavy release cord and a projectile. Increased contact is correlated to increased spin rate. The stiffness of the pouch in the opening direction has similar effects on releasing. The motion of the cords until contact loss depends mostly on inertia. Air drag is irrelevant in that time frame. Looking at the motion of the weapon as it leaves the arm, a longer cracker can only increase friction with the fingers or air drag radially, which can reduce radial speed and thus increase the delay of release. But because of the low speed of the release knot until contact loss, there is very low drag and has little to no effect on the release. Drag does affect the feel after the release. Higher drag will dump a lot of energy which will stop the release cord from hitting you, and it will feel smoother on the follow-through. Heavy release cords will have more energy that needs to be dissipated after release. Tapering the release lowers its mass, resulting in a lower exchange of momentum between projectile and release cord. It will feel smoother because the wave that travels from the pouch to the release won't bounce back the other way to the finger loop and be felt as a pull of the finger. Heavy and tapered slings have this uncomfortable feel from the bounce back wave. A stiff and heavy pouch with a tapered release cord will still have increased delay in the release. A sling with aggressively tapered light release but a stiff and heavy pouch did cause a deflection to the left and turned tennis balls in a positive angle of attack. Observations and effects of cords on rifle spin orientation. I painted dots on tennis balls to observe their orientation and spin. Light slings lose contact faster and the turning effect of the pouch doesn't change the angle of attack of the projectile from the moment of the cord release to the moment of projectile release. Heavier slings do change the angle of attack between release and contact loss. Sometimes the dot is wobbling. It appears the motion is two spins combined. It is not clear what causes this. Another thing that I don't know how to fix is a yaw angle after release. I have observed this across many slings and slingers. The projectile is pulled by the sling in many different ways. It gets deflected inwards until it loses contact with the sling. It gets all spin around its long axis and loses all other spins it had before release. During windup, it has yaw spin and pitch spin, but no roll spin. For a rifle spin release, if a sling has increased delay, there should be compensation by releasing earlier and by changing the motion so that near the release of the cord, the projectile has a slight negative angle of attack. To do this, a heavy sling can be gripped with the release cord in front of the retention cord. Another way to do this is by having a more pronated wrist. Compensating for the delay with tennis balls, using the heaviest sling I have was difficult and took a lot of shots because I needed to change the whole sequence of wrist positions, not only the wrist pronation at the release position. If a heavy sling is gripped as lighter, fast releasing slings, it would turn the projectile during release and give a positive angle of attack. This is visible by the projectile curving to the left from the Magnus force. Using stones, it was easier to compensate. The reason is that stones are denser or heavier and will be affected less by the same sling. This could mean that increasing the projectile mass and sling mass can help you keep similar slinging motions.